G'day there guys, dusting off bad memories and playing them on repeat in my head before I go to sleep every night. Back at it again with another episode of r/Am I the A-Hole. Now if you love this content like I love you, I want you to sit back, relax, chuck a prawn on the barbie, and get ready for some bloody contentious questions. Posted by user Dull Amy, titled, Am I the A-Hole for terrorizing my roommates into cleaning up their crap? So I live with two roommates, 28 male and 21 female, who are less than helpful when it comes to cleaning the house. Wet clothes are left in the washer for days on end. Food is left rotting in the fridge and in the sink for several weeks if I do not clean it. They also just casually throw garbage into the yard. I've asked nicely multiple times for them to clean their mess, and even not so nicely a few times. I am far from the most hygienic person in the world myself. I'll leave dishes until the next day, and just general untidiness. But they take it to a different level. All this filth, since my refusal to clean it anymore, has brought in some new roommates for us. Mainly, giant-ass rats, which seem to have moved into our yard. The kicker is, they are both absolutely terrified of rats. A plan soon hatched in my mind, and with a bit of creativity, some invisible thread and an old bristle broom, I now have a faux rat. I named him Ronald. Every few days or so, for the past 2 weeks-ish, I have been placing it in the corner of the kitchen, waiting for one of them to walk in. Then I yank Ronald as hard as I can at an angle so he shoots towards them. Each time they've ran from the kitchen screaming in fear. I won't lie, I very much enjoyed doing it at first, but kinda felt guilty at having made a grown man bawl his eyes out and thought the lesson has probably been learned. So I decided we had to have a house meeting about the infestation and how they don't feel safe in the home anymore. Personally, I didn't feel safe with a pan of veggie rice rotting on the countertop for 12 days, but hey, ho. I simply stated that if they had just cleaned up their junk, the rats would most likely disappear. Lo and behold, the place was spotless within an hour, and since then there has been a lot less mess. Ronald has been put into retirement and is resting in my bedroom, ready to pounce if ever needed again. But did I take it too far? That's a hard one. I don't think you took it too far. I think you took a chaotic, neutral approach to solving the mess. You didn't directly attack them, you used your associate, Le Rats, to attack them on your behalf. It's a pretty intuitive solution to the problem, and you didn't cause too much harm to them, besides maybe some, you know, PTSD from rats, and potentially a heart attack or two, but you know, the ends justifies the means, right? OP, not the a-hole. Lmao? That's hilarious. Not the a-hole, that's a harmless prank as far as I'm concerned, and more than a fair trade for making you live in the filth. Not the a-hole. This is hysterical and effective. I love your creativity. Picture of Ronald, please. I hope he didn't give us a picture. Also, don't tell your roommates. I feel like they would have the complete lack of self-awareness to understand why that had to be done. Yeah, don't tell your roommates. They'll just double down on not cleaning and find other ways to make your life miserable as well. The key to a good covert operation is never talking about it. Posted by user Gardening Monster, titled, Am I the A-Hole for bringing my garden with me when I moved? I, female 25, have been renting a house since I was 18, for 7 years. When I moved in, the backyard was a large piece of dirt with no lawn or anything, just a decently big backyard with a fence all around. It was a cheap but not great house, but I signed because I wanted the backyard space. Over the past few years, I erected a small garden shed, greenhouse, and pizza oven, transportables, planted lots of veggie gardens in big transportable garden beds, and put down some nice pavers, an aquaponics setup, and generally made the backyard a really green and beautiful place to be. It became the green oasis all my friends gathered at. A few months ago, my landlord let me know that they were planning to sell, and my final move-out day was a week ago. When I left, I brought my garden with me to my new place. Nothing in my last backyard was directly planted into the ground, and nothing permanent. I dismantled the sheds and greenhouse, loaded up all the pots and garden beds onto a truck, and cleared the backyard in 3 days with lots of help. My former landlords are furious over this, and demanded that I return the backyard to the former state. Apparently, they'd listed the house for sale with pictures of the backyard, and potential buyers were walking away from the house when they saw the barren backyard. They're accusing me of stealing their plants and wrecking the backyard. Legally, I'm fine. My contract said I could garden, and I have photos from the first real estate walkthrough before I moved in that show that the backyard was in the same state as I first found it, although with more fertile soil now, probably. The same real estate agent signed off my final inspection, and I got my deposit back. I've received mixed responses though, because I saw the landlords taking pictures of my backyard before I left, but didn't make the connection because, in my honest opinion, when pictures of a house has furniture in it, you don't expect to also get free furniture. Some of my co-workers suggested that I am the a-hole because the house valuation certainly has fallen dramatically because I didn't tell them I was taking my garden with me, so they couldn't plan to landscape before lockdown hit. I'm gonna go with not the a-hole on this one. You absolutely didn't have the intention to have that as a permanent fixture, as it seems like you've been planning that for quite a while, and I think that should make it apparent to the homeowners that, hey, this stuff can move anytime. You haven't come up to me and discussed, hey, you know, you bought all this, but now that it's in our garden, it's our property. So as the ancient saying goes, assumptions make an ass out of you and me. And you've made quite the ass out of these homeowners, and they deserve what's happened to them. Opie, you keep doing you and being fabulous. Not the a-hole. This is a very classic story of landlord trying to benefit off home improvements paid for by the tenant. If your landlord was honest, he would have asked you how much you wanted to leave the garden as it was. You owe him nothing. This, they can pay you for improvements they've allowed you to make over time with your own money. In fact, a similar thing happened to me at my old apartment. I was granted permission to repaint the concrete balcony. I put some lush fake lawn, some timber decking, outdoor furniture, hanging plants, and fairy lights. When the owners were selling, they asked me how much to leave it as it is. I set my price and was literally paid to move out. Win-win all around. The fact they didn't take this route does not make you the a-hole. Good on your landlords for recognizing the value in your improvements. Most people are not a-holes. You just hear about the ones who are. That is correct. However, most people are somewhat selfish, and it is relatively rare for someone to volunteer to pay for something they think they might be able to get for free. The balcony slash yard difference is that a landlord might reasonably expect someone to take their items off a balcony, but might not expect someone to dismantle their garden. So I think a higher number of landlords would not even think of paying someone for the work put into a backyard, because they would just function on the assumption that all work would remain in place when a tenant moved out. Not the a-hole, not at all. If the owners want the garden looking nice, they pay up and put in the effort themselves. Their house value is not your responsibility, and any decent landlord slash owner will put money into a property after a long-term tenant has been there. Just wanted to add that having the garden almost portable was a clever move from OP. Super smart. Also, OP moved in there at 18 and has been doing great. They seem like a cool person. Am realtor, and friends with many landlords. They would be so lucky to get a tenant that takes care of and appreciates their property like OP. OP is a cool person. OP is right. OP is not an a-hole, and OP is totally within her realm to give the landlord the double bird as she skips the hell out of that contract. My landlady has told me and my boyfriend multiple times how grateful she is to have tenants that care about her property. We also love gardening, so have done up what was a very plain gravel slash lawn garden into a nice green space. Everything is in large pots, and we fully intend to take it all with us, including the half wine barrel miniature pond. I can't imagine landlady getting angry at us for taking it when we go. They're my plant babies, not the a-hole OP. Posted by user Throwaway Sad Guy, titled, Am I the a-hole for not marrying the girl I'm supposed to be and causing major problems for my family? This will sound unbelievable to those not from my country. All I can say is that it is real. When I was 5, my parents brought my dad's friend's daughter, X, about 3 years old, to live with me and my sister Y, who was 7. X's family was poor and couldn't support their children. They had 6. So they sent X here because they really trusted my parents. X, Y, and I grew up together, and my parents were awesome to all 3 of us. I had a lot of fun growing up, and I am extremely close to my family. I'm now 29. 3 years back, I went abroad for my master's and then went back to my country. There, I met a girl, P, and we fell in love. I'd like to propose soon, and felt like this would be a good time to introduce P to my family. Y already knew of her, and P just graduated. This weekend, I told my family that I would like for them to meet someone special and set up a video call. No idea who they were expecting, but when they realized P was my girlfriend, everything just blew up. Apparently, they had already discussed and arranged my marriage with X years back, and she was the one I would have to marry. X was aware, her father had told her. Cue lots of screaming and yelling, including some choice words from X to P about how she's a modern girl, euphemism in my culture for tramp, and how she must be after me for my money. She comes from a richer family, by the way. I was just too shocked to react initially. The next day, I told my parents that I look at X as family. They started saying ridiculous things like they've never let her into my room, while apparently Y was allowed, and drawing all sorts of other parallels between X and Y, trying to demonstrate why X wasn't like my sister. They also said stuff like no one can understand me better than X, and that she will keep the family together, while P will alienate me from them. They also told me I'm ruining the family. X also cried non-stop and then shut herself in the room, accusing me of not wanting her only because she was poor amongst other things. She also said no one from her village would marry her now because her family has told everyone back home that she's going to be marrying me. My sister was not aware of any of this either. Now, I told X I don't care that no one will marry her from her village. It is a likely possibility, or that her life is quote-unquote ruined. I also told my parents I won't ruin my life for them to be able to keep their word. X's father is coming to our house once he's able to. Transport restrictions are still in place, but he had a long phone call with my parents. I'm sure a lot of emotional blackmail is to follow, and I already feel rather guilty about X because she's a nice girl. My sister is on my side, but even if my parents cut me off and at the risk of X ruining her life, I am not going to go ahead with this at all. Am I the a-hole? I'ma go with a big fat no. You're not the a-hole for breaking the bounds of a semi-arranged marriage. I'm not sure you were even aware that you were supposed to get married. They can't decide who you get married to. That's not a thing that should happen, in my opinion at least. I don't blame you for your reaction to all of this, and if your parents cut you off, then so be it. They can't force you to do something you don't want to do. You're an adult, not the a-hole. Edit. A lot of people asking me where I'm from. It's a Southeast Asian country. Just don't want to say if it's the exact place you guys are asking about. X was apparently aware that I didn't know, but she was told by my parents and hers that I'm a family man and will do the right thing, so there's no need to worry. She's basically accused me of wrecking the family too. My sister is really upset on my behalf, and also that she wasn't told any of this. My sister's family, her husband and his parents, have said if there's any sort of confrontation, they'll be there to back me up. Not sure if this detail counts, but P is also from my country, but also came abroad to study. So that's not a reason as to why my parents are unaccepting of P, they just want me to marry X. Not the a-hole. Although to some extent it sounds like X is a victim here too. So I think saying you don't care that no one will marry her from her village was a bit harsh. She's obviously been given the impression that you were on board with the idea of marrying her. Your parents are at fault here. If they didn't want you to see X as your sister, they probably should have told you that a few decades ago. Plus, I think he should let X know that he never knew about it, and had he known, he would have put an end to it years ago. If she knew he didn't know, then we know she is manipulative as the rest of his family. If she didn't, it allows her to deal with what happened. I was really harsh, I do agree. but I am flabbergasted that she knew this was the plan, but never even mentioned it once to me. She's apparently known for a long time, but I've had girlfriends even back in school and undergrad. This just makes me believe she thought I'd just break up with all these girls and go for her in the end, which makes me feel so weird. Hey, stepsister, just kidding. She used to act coy around me and everything, but I assume that's because she was awkward about not actually being related. But did she know that you were unaware? That is the key here to understanding her in all of this. I mean, you are not the a-hole, your family is, however, but this is to see if she is or is just a victim as well. My sister is of the opinion that X knew I was unaware. Apparently, she's discussed marriage multiple times before with X when they were younger, like who would you want to marry, which guy do you find cute type conversations. And X never once mentioned that she wants to marry me to her either. Sister believes it's likely that we both were kept out of the loop by my parents and X's parents because they knew I'd not be okay with it, and that if my sister came to know, she'd tell me. I do admit, I've not asked X directly if she was aware that I didn't know, though. Not the a-hole. I think you should talk to X and explain that you never knew, and explain that you do care what happens to her. It sounds like to do after growing up so close. But that it's your parents' responsibility to care for her using their resources, but you are not a resource to be freely given to whoever they want. If it's scandalous for you to talk with her one-on-one, maybe your sister could pass along the message, if you trust her to deliver it accurately. It sounds like your parents promised X's parents that they would take care of her future, and you are a part of the package. I spent several years in a culture like this growing up, and it's understandable from their perspective, but you got out. If you and P can help use your social standing or anything to help get X matched up with a good guy, I think it's worth a try. It would be sad for her to be forced to marry a guy who doesn't treat her well. Again, it's your parents' responsibility to take care of her, not yours. So you really don't have to help, and you definitely don't have to feel guilty for not marrying X. Edit: someone else mentioned the option of helping her get further education, and that's brilliant. Again, not OP's responsibility, but if he wants her to help break the cycle too, then it's worth looking into. If she leaves and finds someone to marry at a university, then she might be considered a wild woman by her village friends and family, but she could have a much more fulfilling life of her choice. Posted by user EnvironmentalCat48, titled, "Am I the a-hole for telling my mother-in-law she needed to leave after she told my husband he married a lemon?" My mother-in-law was over at our house, and I've been feeling pretty bad lately. I'm 18 weeks pregnant with a little boy. I have 3 other children from a previous marriage, and we have a ton of farm animals and dogs that I take care of during the day. Just taking care of the animals is a chore itself. It involves shoveling, bending, pushing, and lifting, and often chasing something that makes a break for it, since my kids often open the gate and forget to close it. The children can also be a handful. My 2-year-old is very whiny and clingy, and cries at the drop of a pen. Anyways, I was folding some laundry in the living room, and my husband and mother-in-law came in. I hadn't seen my husband yet, and he came over and gave me a kiss and asked me about my day. I told him I was hurting in my back and was having some Braxton Hicks contractions, so he said, "Baby, you don't have to do the laundry or cook dinner today. I'll do it. If you don't feel like doing anything at all when I come home, I'll do it and you can just hang out with the kids and rest." I thanked my husband and told him I would still fold the laundry, but I would love if he would make dinner. Later that evening, I was giving the kids a bath in the bathroom, but I overheard my mother-in-law tell my husband that he married a lemon and he could probably do better than me. Angry, I came out of the bathroom and told her she needed to leave the house. My husband understands it hurt my feelings, but my mother-in-law keeps calling me and leaving messages on how I was rude to her for kicking her out of her son's house. Am I the a-hole? Edit: since I'm answering some of the same questions, I'll type this out. My son isn't a brat. He's just 2 and acts 2. I also clean and make breakfast and lunch. I don't just let the kids starve all day. My children's dad left when my son was born because he was an NICU baby and he didn't want to deal with a sick baby. He then ran off into the sunset with a younger, childless woman. I met my husband when my son was 3 months old. We lived together before we got married. He built the house, but I help pay for the land. I'm laid off at the moment due to coronavirus. My husband and I just married last month, but we've been together for longer than that. My husband is very kind and gentle, and he didn't have time to respond to his mum as I came out almost immediately when I heard it because I'm hormonal and was tired and it hurt my feelings. I don't know why those were relevant questions, but there you are. Good on you, OP. Good on you for standing up for yourself. That's despicable, disgusting behavior that shouldn't be accepted in today's society. Oh, you married a lemon because she has 3 kids, you can do better. Actually, shut your mouth. The mother-in-law probably knows full well the circumstances of OP's life, probably knew that the husband walked out on her. Fair enough, we don't know the complete story, we have this version of events, but I'm more inclined to believe her, with the 3 kids, who's had a man abandon his family. Dear Lord, that is not a good situation to be put in, especially in a time like now. OP, you sound like a saint, your husband sounds like a very lucky man to have you, and I'm so grateful that you found happiness. That mother-in-law can go kick rocks, pound sand, and get tackled by an emu for all I care. You're not the a-hole, dear Lord. I'm already on team not the a-hole from the title, but hold on. Did your mother-in-law say her son's house? Not, you know, the house that both of you live in? The house that is also your house? Is she delusional? Does she think that your husband is the lord of the manor and that you're not his equal? You'd catch me singing to the mother-in-law. This house is his house. This house is my house. But either way, ma'am, it sure is not your house. Greetings, communist comrade. I'd just like to remind you that your karma is my karma and your rewards are my awards. Fork him over. Not the a-hole. Who criticizes a pregnant woman in her own house? A pregnant woman with a toddler on a farm, plus 2 other children. She's 18 weeks pregnant with a little boy and 3 other children, 4 total, plus a farm. So she has 4 hungry children and a crop in the field. I don't get the reference. I don't get it. Posted by user, just barge right in. Titled, Am I the A-hole for kicking my roommate out for something that her friend did? I am a 37-year-old man, and my roommate is an early 30s woman. I rent a 2-bedroom house, and it had a spare room, so I decided to look for a roommate last year. I had a couple of people interested, but a friend asked me for a favor, and I let her move in. She pays about 30% of the rent, because that's all she can afford. My roommate has one particularly good friend who she invites over regularly. I do not like that woman at all. She is loud, self-centered, and has no concept of boundaries, property, or privacy. She has accidentally eaten my food and drunk my beer several times when she came over, and I have voiced my opinion about her to my roommate regularly. My roommate's response has always been, as long as I'm paying my part of the rent, the company I keep is between them and me. On Saturday night, she invited her friend over. As I often am in my room, I was completely naked, lying over my covers, reading a book. I like being naked and expect a reasonable amount of privacy from civilized people. Man, I thought I was the only one that did that. When my roommate was in the bathroom, my door flew open like it was rammed by a siege engine. Her friend had barged in to surprise me, and instead of frantically apologizing for violating my privacy and seeing me naked, she burst out laughing as I fumbled to cover myself. By now, my roommate had come out of the bathroom, and her friend shouted, "I saw his little pecker!" My roommate snort laughed loudly. The next morning, my roommate was hungover, and so I told her that her time in this house was over and that she had a month to vacate. I looked up the laws in my state, and since I'm the only person on the lease, I can legally kick her out as long as I give her proper notice. She told me that she warned her roommate about privacy after what happened, and I told her I don't care at all. She brought that woman into the house. She was entertained by my embarrassment, and I wasn't comfortable living with her for another day. I told her if it were legal, I'd kick her out that second. My roommate has been nasty with me all week, saying that she has nowhere to go. I don't care, and keep telling her that she might want to start looking. Our mutual friend, who I originally did the favor for, has sided with her completely, and so I just blocked him. Am I going too far here, or am I not the a-hole in this case? I wouldn't describe your actions as being an a-hole. I'm just saying that you're very forward, and you're like burning everything, and I love it. It's like a bloody minefield going off, and we're just watching the fireworks. OP, you really do be a savage right now, and you're doing everything right. You're doing what everyone in the shower wishes they had the courage to do. They're like, damn it, why didn't I do that? God, I could have been so direct. Imagine the look on their face. Now, if we reverse the roles, as we always do in situations like this, imagine the amount of charges you'd get as a man walking in on a woman like that. Imagine how shut down you would be on social media, the shame you'd get from your friends if you did that. Just because the roles are reversed in this situation doesn't make it okay for her to do that. And I'm sure if it was the other situation, the police would be there instantly, kicking that man out, and it would be completely justified. I say burn those bridges as fast as you can, and don't look back. They did you so dirty, and you deserve to live worry-free without that nasty woman in the house. Not the a-hole. Not the a-hole. Your roommate is responsible for her guest's behaviors. Stealing by her friend would have been enough to kick her out, but laughing at you instead of kicking her friend out after she treated you like that was far out of line. She doesn't deserve better. She enabled her friends to make you feel unsafe for your privacy in your own home, and nobody has to live like that. It's just the consequences of her actions. In my opinion, she's welcome to go move in with the rude friend and leave the nude friend. Not the a-hole. You might want to make sure you send her the notice by email too, so you had written proof she had it so you can legally change the lock and dump her stuff on the street in a month if she hasn't done anything about getting another place. That's a really good idea. I just sent her one just stating that I was officially telling her to vacate the house. Not just a good idea, legally required in most states. Everything needs to be in writing, physical writing. You don't have to specify a reason. Date and sign what you send, hand it to her personally, and make sure she reads it. But first, check whether your state requires service by certified mail. Isn't an email writing? I think they meant it's not only a good idea, but that it's also legally necessary. Otherwise, I'm at a loss as well. No, apparently not. Ran into this with my landlord. He refused to acknowledge via email, so I had to send via mail, and he acknowledged the next day. Posted by user, Love My Dogs, titled, Am I the A-hole for refusing to support our daughter after she gives birth? That's not very cash money. How do you love your dogs if you're gonna do that? I'm not going to go into real detail, but essentially, my 27 female daughter has recently said some very racist things. Since she married her husband, she seems to have changed as a person and is much more distant and vicious towards the family. Things came to a head last weekend at our first big family get-together since COVID when she said that our eldest daughter's adopted son, who is black, he was adopted because our eldest and her husband are unable to have children, wasn't really part of the family. That's a yikes from me, dog. And that God didn't mean for you, eldest daughter, to have children, just accept what he gave you and stop forcing your options, referring to the son on the rest of us. Ah, that's a big yikes from me, dog. What the hell? Our eldest and her son were devastated, and some very heated words were exchanged before my 27-year-old daughter and her husband stormed out. Now, recently, our 27-year-old daughter has announced that she is pregnant. She and her husband were planning on moving into the cottage on our property after the baby is born, so my wife and I can help out for the first year. During this time, our daughter doesn't plan on working and has been clear that she expects us to contribute to her financial costs during the year. We had a similar arrangement with our eldest when she was trying for a baby, and our son and his wife also spent 6 months living in the cottage after their twins were born. However, after discussing with my wife, we feel that this would make the rest of the family uncomfortable with visiting us. Obviously, eldest and her son no longer want to come over, while 27 female and her husband are here, and our son's Latina wife has also expressed her discomfort around 27 female and her husband, and we are uncomfortable supporting people who are so blatantly racist. We told our daughter last Thursday in a Zoom chat about our decision, and she blew up at us, demanding to know why she wasn't allowed to express her option or opinion, and arguing that we aren't black, so why should we care? My wife became very upset and closed the chat and has refused to speak to our daughter since, and she is blaming herself for not raising her better. Are we the a-holes here? Edit, thank you so much for your kind responses. I've tried to read all the comments, but this blew up overnight. However, some general things. 1. Our 27 female daughter assumed she could live with and be financially supported by us in the year after her child was born because our eldest went through significant financial hardship when she was trying to have a baby due to paying for IVF and fertility treatments, and as a result, almost ended up homeless because they remortgaged their house to afford it. But then her husband was in a car accident and needed time off work, meaning they were unable to pay their mortgage and the bank claimed their home. Can anyone tell me if OP knows what a full stop is? 2. I don't know what I can say to convince you this is real. Yes, this is from a throwaway because my main account has part of my real name on it and both my 27 female daughter and my son and his wife are familiar with it. There were 3 edits to this post. Originally, it included a couple of paragraphs about how our 27 female daughter made some homophobic comments about my wife's brother getting married to another man, and also some statements she made towards the Black Lives Matter movement. However, that post was over the 3,000 word count, and I decided to remove them as they aren't applicable to the current situation, and I want to focus more on our immediate family issue, rather than getting into a big LGBT/Black Lives Matter argument. When I reposted it, the post was removed because this is not a debate sub, so I changed the title and reposted it as it is. 3. My wife and I have been supporters of the Black Lives Matter movement since before we got married 33 years ago. I came from a very racist family who disowned my older sister for marrying a black man and then kicked me out as a 16-year-old for sneaking out of the house so I could go to my sister's wedding. We haven't really been LGBT supporters. We haven't been anti-LGBT, just not a part of the rallies and donations. Until my wife's brother came out a few years ago, and since then, we have made more of an effort to go to the parades and donation to things like the Trevor Project. Second edit to say that our 27-year-old daughter will not be homeless if we don't support her for the year following the birth. It was just supposed to be an opportunity for her to spend time with us, as otherwise, they will live 2 hours away. As far as I'm aware, they own their home outright, and her husband is financially well off enough to support her during this time without our help. Also, our adoptive grandson is only 9, so a bit young to understand why some parts of the family don't like him. Whoa, you have spelled it out right there. Okay, OP, you're definitely not the a-hole. I think we've made that one very clear here. What has gone wrong in this woman's life that she's turned down this dark path? I want to make all the jokes in the world, but this is not a laughing matter. That is despicable behavior. And I'm surprised the entire family hasn't cut her out for these disgusting actions. Dear Lord. I know you people down in the comments don't advocate for cutting someone out of your life, but come on, someone this intense that is willing to be that vindictive and argumentative and not change their ways? Is it worth having someone like that in your life? Or do you cut your losses? If it were me, I'd fight it and I'd call them out at every opportunity if I continue to keep them in my life, because it's not okay to hold those views. It's just not. So OP, absolutely don't let her live in your house. She's got a husband that wants to support her and keep her in a little echo chamber, and so be it. Keep being awesome, OP. You're not the a-hole. I love you. I love what you stand for. Thank you for donating to those causes. It's amazing to see. Not the a-hole. You don't owe your daughter anything here. Actions always have consequences. While she may be technically allowed to share her opinion, that doesn't mean that others are not allowed to react to it. She has to live with the consequences of her actions, and you and your wife are well within your rights to decide that your home and financial support are no longer open to her. She announced that she believes your grandson is not a part of the family, and that's a terrible thing to say no matter the circumstances. You're allowed to be hurt and to react. I'd like to add a little to this response. You can't blame yourself for your daughter's behavior. Racism is learned, and your other daughter is evidence that you didn't teach her racism. You said that she changed after she got married. That's probably the source. Family is no reason to accept others' beliefs that you find morally reprehensible. More addition to this, you are being excellent parents by teaching her actions have consequences. As my 65-year-old mother says about her two 40-something kids with kids of our own, you stop parenting, but you never stop teaching through your own actions and example. Edit. Yep, guys. What is that edit? Yes! What they are doing is exactly what people mean when they say to speak up and not accept the racism of others. When someone shows how racist they are, the easiest thing you can do is drop them. Their daughter can now learn that if she is going to be racist, her family won't tolerate her or her beliefs. Don't forget that your behavior in this situation will also affect your grandson immensely. I'm not sure how old he is, but if you allow your daughter to remain in the family spewing hate at your black grandson, and he sees that behavior being tolerated by his grandparents, this decision may scar him for life. What this would communicate to him is that he is not as deserving of love and respect, even if that's not your intention. Absolutely this. If he feels his grandparents don't stand up to his racist aunt, he may not trust you or feel safe to be himself around you, and would feel that he's not part of the family. Put your words into actions. Definitely not the a-hole for fighting racism in your family. Yuck, yuck, guys, we love getting heated at the end of the episodes, don't we? Unfortunately, this is the end of the line for this episode for me today, so hope you guys enjoyed it. Tell me what you thought of it down in the comments below. Outro Marky is going to repeat the same line, but I love you more than he does, so make sure you do tell me. Hope you guys have a good day, night, sleep, whatever you're up to. I'll see you in the next one. Say hi to Outro Marky. Alright guys, that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this one today. Tell me what you thought of it down in the comments below. If you're not subscribed to the channel, I would love you to subscribe because I love your face and I love seeing you here every single day that you are here in this video. I don't know what else to say today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the content. I do have a second channel that's called Marky2. Link should be up on the screen somewhere here if you don't have Adblock installed. If you don't know where to find the channel, you can go to my main page. Just click on the Marky face and it should be on the right somewhere there, or on channels if you're on phone. Hope you guys have a good one. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.